Did you ever get a refund from a vendor for a bill that was paid a long time ago? Well, if that's the case, then you would have to record that refund into QuickBooks Online the way we will learn in this video. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Refunds from vendors could be from past transactions with vendors, such as checks, expenses, and bill payments. This video will address refunds from bill payments specifically, and that means the bill was entered and the payment for that bill was entered later, and then that bill payment was refunded. That's the situation we will learn about here in this video. There are three simple steps when recording a refund from a past bill payment. First, you must record a vendor credit for the bill that the refund payment was applied to. Secondly, you must make a deposit for the money received and put the vendor in the Received From field when you use the deposit window. And third, you must apply the deposit to the credit memo with a $0 payment. For example, let's imagine on April 16th, we received a credit from Con Edison for bill number 6161 for the full $1,000. The refund was deposited directly into the bank account. Well, step one says you must record a vendor credit for the bill that the refund payment was applied to. Okay, let's do that now. We come here to the QuickBooks Online and we click New and we come across to vendor credit. Now, it said the vendor was Con Edison and the date was April 16th of 2017. Remember, the year is very important to get right. Now, of course, if it's Con Edison, we know that it must be electric expense, because that's the only expense associated with Con Edison, and the amount of the credit is 1,000. Now, we're going to click Save and Close. Now, when we look at the unpaid bill report, you can see that the credit that we just made for Con Edison is here. But what is not here is bill number 6161, and that means we cannot apply this credit to the bill that it was actually supposed to be applied to. That's the reason they gave us the money. So, and now we'll do step two in this process. We'll actually record a deposit for that $1,000 check, and we'll put Con Edison in the Received From field. We click the plus sign and go over to Bank Deposit. Now, the date of the bank deposit would be April 16th of 2017. Now, don't worry if you see a little bit of a difference up here on top. That's because I'm fixing these videos in a little bit of a different order. But the most important part is to scroll down and choose Con Edison in the Received From field. Now, the account in this case is accounts payable, because it affects the balance because this is a refund from a paid bill. So we choose the accounts payable account, not electric expense. We already handled the decrease in electric expense when we recorded the credit memo a moment ago. Now, we put $1,000 as the amount of the deposit, And that's all we have to do. Save and close. And now we'll do step three. Now, before we move on to step number three, applying the deposit to the credit memo with a $0 payment, we should take a quick look at what the unpaid bill report looks like before we do the last step. So we click Reports, Unpaid Bills. Now notice, the deposit and the credit are both showing on the unpaid bill report. That's because anything on the unpaid bill report is simply what has not yet been applied to another transaction. At the moment we do step three, this deposit and this credit will both disappear from the unpaid bill report because they will have been applied to each other. So let's go ahead and apply them to each other. We click New, and we go over to the Vendor column, and we click Pay Bills. Now the date is still April of 2017. They all happen on the same date. The date that we get the deposit, that's the date that this happens. Now again, we have to make sure that we're choosing all dates and that the payee is just Con Edison. So we can see, here it is. This is the $1,000 deposit. It's almost like a bill that adds to the balance because we receive the money from them. But if we click the check mark, look what happens. $1,000 credit is put right here in credit applied. So again, this is the deposit and this is the amount. Where is this $200 coming from? This $200 are the other two credits combined. We're only taking the $1,000 credit that we entered as a result of this specific deposit, and we are applying it to this specific deposit. And that will fix everything in the vendor records. Save and close. And when we come back to the unpaid bill report, we see that the deposit is gone and that the $1,000 vendor credit is gone. The only remaining vendor credits are these two together, or actually these three, that add up to $200 in their open amount.